Today, I shall discuss a problem about impulse turbine. Let's start the problem. The problem is given for D-level type. However, I am starting this problem. This problem is given for an impulse steam turbine of D level types. The nozzle angle having of 16 degree delivers 1 kg of steam per second at a speed of 720 meter per second to a set of blades moving at 180 meter per second. The blade angle at outlet is 25 degree and blade velocity coefficient is 0.72. Determine one power developed. Second, blade efficiency. Third, the energy lost in the blade. This problem given here, for impulse turbine of D level types. The level or D level types what it have given, but we have to go through the values given for this problem. First of all, you can see that the nozzle angle having of 16 degree. That means we can write the given data are, one is the nozzle angle, that is alpha, that is 16 degree. Delivers 1 kg of steam, that is m dot s is 1 kg per second. At a speed of 720 meter per second, that is V1, the nozzle steam velocity is 720 meter per second. That is the speed of 720 meter per second. To a set of blade moving at the blade's velocity is moving blade velocity is 180. That is VV is 180 meter per second. The blade angle at outlet is 25 degree, that is phi, that is 25 degree. The blade angle outlet is 25 degree and blade velocity coefficient is 0.72, that is K, which is VR2 by VR1, that is 0.72. Okay, now start the problem. Before the starting of this problem, we have to draw the velocity diagram. The velocity diagram like that. Now, this value VB, that is 180. Okay. Now, this is V1, that is 720. This one. Now, take this A, this is B, this is C, and this is D. This value is VF1. This value is VW1. This is VW2. The component of this, if this value is V1 equals to 720, then this will be V2. And this is VR1. So, this will be VR2. Okay. Now, start. We have to find this angle also given. This is alpha, that is 16 degree. This is phi. Okay. This is phi 25 degree. Now, we have to find this angle, which is theta. By this theta, we can find this VR1 and go to this VR2. So, this is the inlet triangle. We have to find the data for inlet triangle and we have to go to the outlet triangle. This one is the outlet triangle. Now, first, we have to find this value AB. AB. What is AB? That is, this angle is given 16 degree. So, this is 720 into cos 16 degree minus 180. This value will come, this value is obtained. Next I am going about that. Before that we have to find VF1. VF1 is V1 sine, this is V1 sine 16 degree. Okay. Now we have to find this theta here. Theta is the tan inverse VF1 by AB. This will come V1 sine 16 degree by AB, that is 720 into cos 16 degree minus 180. This equals to, we know this V1 is 720, so directly we can find this theta will come. Before that I am going through this 198.458, and this value is 720 cos 16 degree minus 180. This value will come 21 degree. So theta we got 21 degree. Okay. Now we have to find this VR1 is VF1 by sine theta. We've taken this sine because this angle for this direction not available in this direction. So this will be sine. So the relation between this VF1 and VR1 will go for the sine. And this value VR1 is VF1 sine theta. And this value will come V1 sine 16 degree by sine 21 degree. Because theta is 21 degree and VF1 we got the V1 sine 16 degree. So this value will come 5, 5, 3.785. Okay. Now, as we know, this K equals to 0.72. K is given 0.72. So VR2 equals to 0.72 into VR1. This equals to 0.72 into 3.785. This value is obtained is 398. Now we got the VR2, value of VR2. We have to find the VW2. We know VW2 equals to VR2 cos 25 degree minus 180, because VR2 cos 25 degree, that's mean this value B2D, and this value is 180. So if we minus this 180 from B to D, we got this value C to D. This equals to VW2. Okay. Now this value will come 181.367. Okay. Now we got all these datas. We have to find, we got this VW2, and the VW1 is A to C. VW1 equals to A to C, that is AC. This will come V1 cos 16 degree, that is 720 minus 720 into cos 16 degree. This value is obtained is 692.108. Okay. Now we know the formula of power equals to m dot s into VW1 plus VW2 into VB. We know all these values. This is m dot s equals to 1, VW1 equals to 692.108. plus VW2 is 181.367 into VB is 180. This value is 157.225. Okay, this is kilowatt. Now we have to find this efficiency, turbine efficiency, the diagram efficiency. This efficiency equals to the formula is work done, by kinetic energy. Work done is power, and kinetic energy half m dot s v1 square. This power is 157.225 into 10 to the power 3, because it is kilowatt, so we have to convert into watt. And this is half, ms is 1, this ms is given 1, into v1 is 720. You can see this 720, so this is 720 square. This value will come 0.606, that is 60.6%. Okay, now find the energy lost. energy lost, the formula is the kinetic energy, relative kinetic energy change, that is half m dot s into vr1 square minus vr2 square. This value is half into m dot s 1, and vr1, the formula is vr1 is 553.785 whole square. We got the vr1 already got 553, you can see the 553.785, so I have written 553.785 here, minus vr2, this value also given here, 398 whole square. This value will come 741.36.913. This equals to 74.136 kilowatt.